Caroline, where can you be? I keep calling things classics when they're not. Today we are talking about the 2007 motion picture Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist. You may be wondering why am I looking down. I just want to make sure that it actually came out in 2007. Am I wrong? Eight! This hour and a half long motion picture spans the crazy night two teenagers and their friends spend around New York trying to find Nora's best friend, Caroline, a drunken party girl mess. Ultimately, it's a love story. Spoiler alert. This is based on a book by David Levithan and some chick whose name I don't remember, but the book is really good and the movie definitely reflects the teen angst of the book and the music snobbery, which is part of my attraction to it because I myself am a big fat music snob. It speaks to me on a level deeper than just motion picture, but also musically. I'm gonna eat cake because I'm hungry.
This is really rude, but I haven't eaten dinner, so deal with it. Why are you eating cake for dinner?
Because I can. I love the story. I love the progression of events. Caroline is known for getting drunk on this fateful night. Nick's girlfriend broke up with him for this young, really ugly kid. And he has a gig with his band that doesn't have a name or a drummer. And Nora is going out with Caroline because Caroline and Nora heard through the grapevine that their favorite band, Where's Fluffy, was going to be performing somewhere. Now, Where's Fluffy is this fictitious band that never announces shows or hasn't played a show or something like that. It's hilarious. It's ironic. It's pretentious. Where's Fluffy? Don't know. You gotta find him. So Caroline goes out and gets drunk and then she gets lost. And so while they are both trying to find Fluffy, they are also trying to find Caroline. Nick's gay friends. Are trying to get him to hook up with Nora because they think she's a really good person. Nora, while she is the second title character, is truly the hero of the story. She is just the most dynamic character. She is selfless, yet strong and powerful and independent and vulnerable, and she just has so much more to her than any other character. It's more about her than Nick. Even though it's supposed to be about the both of them, I definitely feel like Nora is the driving force behind everything. Obviously, because she is trying to find Caroline, whereas everyone else is just trying to find Fluffy. Or if you're Nick, love. This movie definitely, as a film about music, explores a lot of music. It's just such a important universal theme that I definitely think people my age identify with more. Music is more of a common denominator amongst people my age because we have so many different formats to listen to music and to connect because of music that I really like this movie because it definitely explores that and explores how important it is to have similar musical interests as someone you're interested in. Because if you don't have something to talk about, what's the point? Especially if you don't have favorite bands, like, why are you alive? That'd be rude, but, you know. The cast is all perfect. Everybody, you know, is easy to see in their roles. Especially if you read the book afterwards, you can totally, like, understand why they cast the cast the way they did. Even before I saw the movie and I read the book, and like I knew that Kat Dennings and Michael Cera were playing Nick and Nora, you could see them in those roles. It's a short, sweet tale of love between teenagers. It's got a good message about doing what you want to do when you want to do it. We're only young once. Why not? Why not be happy with your life? Right? Right. If I didn't love this movie already, I would love it because of the two SNL cameos you will see, as well as Bishop Allen jumping in, playing a course of middle management. Nick and Norris, check it out.
They had put a fart machine into my sleeping bag.